Hello everybody, and welcome to this video where I'm going to explain how to get the best of the new traditional airbrushes in Krita. You are asking for easy tutorials, and I think this is easy and powerful at the same time. I have created three different brushes to produce different effects, so let me show you in a very simple way what can we achieve with them. But first, we need to load the bundle. We go to the settings, manage resources, and then I go to the import bundles and I look in my desktop for the bundle file. Okay, Airbrush 2021 bundle. I click and accept, and now it's instantly loaded inside Krita. That's it. It's already done. Click on accept, and you can see these three different brushes. They have this tag called Airbrush. If you want to load the tag, obviously you have to restart Krita to load those new resources. Let's create a new file, and then I can isolate the airbrush tag. So why I select these new behaviors to create new brushes? You are gonna get a lot of fun, believe me. The first thing you are going to notice is that these brushes are using, let me change the color, are using the tilt feature. Okay, so you can see how is responsive to the changes in the angle I use with my Wacom device, or your another brand device if has the tilt feature. Okay, and now I'm going to show you how we can change the setting, because maybe you think, yeah, but this curve is not perfect for me. So I go to the brush editor, press F5. Okay, if I go to the size, I control the size by the tilt elevation. Okay, and I use this curve. So in this angle position, I get very visible mark. It's like almost zero. But if I go decreasing the angle like this, I get bigger size. Okay, and why is this point here? This point is here because there are users that use the mouse, because if I use with my mouse, I get this. But if I use the tilt feature and this is not here, for example, like this, then I get nothing. Okay, so this is important. By default, I'm pretty sure you have the opacity value here. So if I change this opacity to 35, or it takes a more time to arrive 100% value. Why I think these brushes are really cool? Because if I take a selection, for example, square selection, a rounded selection like this, I get my airbrush, and I can control very easy how soft in the same brush stroke I can go. Okay, so I can create beautiful gradients for cylinders or for spheres. Can create something like this really easy, really fast. Okay, and the grain, you can see automatically, is in pixel size, and this is related with the size in with the brush tip, and I use the randomness, which controls how transparent or opaque are the points inside the brush tip. Okay, if I reduce completely, I disable the effect, and you can see the difference. And what about this? Where is the symbol here? I put this symbol here because I want to make sure that I can control the texture by the pattern. And you can have something like this. And if you are using the latest release of Krita, you can have the pattern scale right here, just selecting from here. Okay, you can add with the plus button and you have the pattern scale. So I can control the grain because this is another way to control how grainy my airbrush can look. Okay, I go to the texture and then I see that this is my texture selected. But if I go to the default resources, for example, this grain, I can create another kind of different textural effect. And you can see the grain is different. In fact, airbrushing is really fun, and I'm sure you will enjoy them a lot. Have fun and happy painting, and remember to receive the latest videos and news I publish in the community tab, activating the notifications bell. Thanks for being here and supporting Krita. Bye! Okay, so here we go with the mini demo. As you can see, I'm going to use the same size during the mini demo, add 600 pixels, and also the dynamic brush tool with these settings to create a more stabilized brush stroke. Okay, I find that the stabilizers are good, but this tool provides me a nice feeling. Now I'm in shading, I'm looking the 80s technique, and as you can see, you can use the quick setting soccer, because if you don't have the tilt feature, you can change the size really fast with this docker. Now I'm finishing adding some details in her shading in the nose, and I think it's quite done for a sketch to show the power of the new airbrushes in Krita. Thanks for watching.